let's not look at stress lightly and just think, okay, I'm stressed, I'll be okay the next day. Some people actually don't know how to handle stress so much that it can become a very big issue if it's not handled correctly. And doctor, let's talk about human pressure or blood pressure as one of the things that can easily be sparked off by stress.
Yes. Human blood pressure, for those of you who have done some mathematics up to P2, up to primary 2, is equal to cardiac output per minute. That's the rate at which the heart is pumping out blood into the arteries, times arterial resistance, means the problems the blood is finding in going through the arteries. That means that measures the blood pressure. The normal human blood pressure should be between 90 to 140, over 60 to around 90. That's because it's always a range. Blood pressure is not a constant, but it fluctuates. But it must fluctuate within the normal range.
Yes.
Now, some of the fact. What are some of the factors?
The major causes.
Causes that causes the pressure to go up in a human being.
Yes.
One. Only two things will cause pressure to go up. Either increase in cardiac output or resistance. Let's start with the resistance. Of course, what causes the resistance? The resistance can be caused by one, diet. If you are eating wrong foods, metabolism is very bad, then you start getting fats clogging into the arteries. That means the arteries are going to narrow. Okay? And when they narrow, the blood starts passing there by force. So the pressure goes up. And even after narrowing, the blood starts even injuring the outer linings of the arteries, causing the white blood cells to come there. So the arteries start lower, becoming small. Well, the moment the arteries become small, that means the pressure is going to go up. If you look at that formula, blood pressure is equal to cardiac output, CO times resistance. Now, the resistance is going to go up. Why? Because the arteries have become narrow. That is number one. Another thing that can cause the resistance to be high is too much. For example, if somebody is taking a lot of salt, and you know, when you have to take a lot of salt, now the kidney cannot absorb out water from the blood at a rate it should, so a lot of water remains in the blood. Now, as long as there is too much water in the blood, that means the volume of the blood is increased, so it is going to have to find a problem in going through the arteries.
Yes.
So that means resistance has gone up. And when resistance goes up, what happens? The pressure has to shoot up. Then, when you come to cardiac output, when somebody gets stressed, the stresses we've been talking about, there are a lot of hormones which are released, which increase the rate at which the heart is pumping. So the heart, the cardiac output, the heart starts pumping out of the normal. So it is pumping more blood than it's supposed to pump through the arteries. And as long as the cardiac output goes up, definitely the pressure has to go up.
Yes.
So those are, so now some people have a combination. He has a combination of the cardiac output problem, a combination of the resistance. So all these cause what we call the pressure to go up. But of course, the major factor here for high blood pressure, there could be other factors, but I think 80%, if you are not eating foods which are not compatible to your blood group and genotype, you are not doing the right exercises, and you are not doing the right lifestyle strategies, you are likely to have high blood pressure depending on your body system.
Okay, so, now doctor, there's high blood pressure, and many a times that's what we hear as probably something deadly. Is it the same with low blood pressure?
No, low blood pressure is actually the reverse. It may be a result of the heart weakening, pumping very little blood through the arteries, the pressure will be low. Or the dilation of the arteries may become wide because of some drugs and so on, so many factors. And when the arteries become wide, the pressure will go low.
Is it as life-threatening?
It is fatal, because that means little blood will go through to go and take oxygen and other food nutrients in the other part of body systems. Therefore, you are likely even to faint, because if blood is delayed to take it to the brain, you are going to have blackouts. So that is one of the that's the low blood pressure. But this high blood pressure, you see, it's the reverse of the low blood pressure. When you look at what is the effect of the high blood pressure, of course you can see one, if you look at that video, the arteries themselves. Arteries, the blood is squeezing to go through the arteries, causing inflammation of the arteries inside and causing a lot of blood cell, white blood cells to come around that area, and that is even restrict more. That's number one. Two, when the pressure goes, as you see there, that VD again, if you look at the kidney, look at the when the pressure increases into the kidney is going to become malfunctional.
Mm-hmm.
Three, in the eyes, you see, look, if you look at that video showing the capillaries in the eyes, when the pressure starts goes on at very, 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 pressure becomes high into those capillary, blood capillaries, mm-hmm. they are likely to cause impairment in vision. Then another thing that you have to look at also with pressure is in the brain. Now here it is two way. You see, as you see that video, blood going through the brain. Now when you still look at that blood going through the brain, at times, because the blood now is becoming thick, it is finding a lot of resistance, it can go at times midway on the brain. It gets completely stuck and it blocks particular arteries. Now those arteries in the brain, when they are blocked, which are supposed to take blood to a particular point of the body system, that part of the body system is going to lack oxygen and you're going to get a stroke. That's what people wake up when one day they find he's paralyzed one side. They see he has got a stroke, but he would not hear. The man was okay. I think it is witchcraft. It's not witchcraft. That's the problem. Then at times, that's why strokes are mainly for particular body. They can get anybody that they are more of problems of blood group A and AB. Why? Because for them, they have a problem with metabolism. They have an enzyme called intestinal alkaline phosphatase, which they have in limited quantities, and they're not supposed to break down cholesterol. That's why the blood group A and ABs are more prone victims of stroke, cardiac problems, and most of the diabetes mellitus. Now, then at times, especially for our brothers, the blood group O's, who have very thin blood, the blood, as it makes an effort to pass through the capillaries, it bursts them. And when it bursts them, that's when you hear that the arteries in the brain burst, and the person maybe went slept very well. Only in the following day, instead of waking up, he's placed in a coffin.
They didn't wake up.
So that is some of the challenges of the high blood pressure. Of course, it impairs also sexual dysfunction, because it ends up letting the sexual capillaries, the arteries into the penis and so on and so on, and makes somebody lose sex libido. So those are some of the bigger challenges of high blood pressure. Now, most people who deal with high blood pressure, especially the Western medicine and so on, they mainly focus mainly at reducing the arterial resistance. And this arterial resistance is usually relaxed by some tablets like amdolpin and so on, which relax the muscle. When the artery muscles are relaxed, that means the blood will go through the arteries when it is relaxed. But they have not removed the root cause of what is causing the resistance
temporary.
To be there. That's why most people on blood medicine, high blood pressure medicine, if you look at the side effects, they tell you it will cause you dizziness, it can cause you to be weak because it weakens, ends up weakening the entire muscular body system. There are some tablets which they give trying to remove some of the clogged fats and so on from the arteries, but you are removing the clogged fats, but you are not dealing with what is causing these fats to go in. That's why you see high blood pressure becomes a problem in many people to treat it. Now, at Timex Nutrition Center, for us, what we do is very simple. As we showed, we start up with the diet. If you are eating the right foods with your blood group and genotype, then I'm very sure you are not going to have the arterial resistance. The fats inside are going to be left clogged out. I'm giving you exercise to do. I'm giving you stressy techniques, so cardiac output is going to be stabilized. We have some supplements which we give. You take them only for 30 days, and then the pressure should be able to normalize. However, you may continue with the chemical medication for some time, because for it, as we have seen, it relaxes the muscle, which keeps the blood low, as you are. But because for us, we tackle the root cause of what is causing the pressure. Eventually, you find that when the patients go back to their physicians, they go on reducing dosage. Instead of increasing dosages, they go on reducing dosages. Then some of them, they start telling them, okay, now don't take any medicine until a week, 2 weeks. And then some of them, you find they eventually leave off pressure. So this myth, which used to be that high blood pressure doesn't cure, it's not correct.
It's not
correct. It will cure if you are really determined for this high blood pressure to go. As long as you're not changing your lifestyle strategies, you're not changing your diet, it has nowhere to go.
Right. Well, your solution is here at Timex Nutrition Center. Come through and get help. Otherwise, it looks like that's our time. Thank you so much, Doctor. And thank you so much for watching. NBS, always have a good night.